Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to learn more about friction. Topics which will be covered are: first is introduction to friction, second is causes of friction, that is what happens at microscopic level, third is coefficient of friction, fourth is types of friction, and at the last, fifth is what are the advantages and disadvantages of friction. So, what is friction? In simple words, it is the force that resists the relative motion between surfaces in contact, and its direction is opposite to the relative velocity. Now, we will see with the example of wooden box sliding over the table surface from one end to other. So, as you can see, I want to slide this yellow wooden box over the table surface from left end to right. Now to slide the box, I need to apply some force. So as soon as I apply the force to slide the box, frictional force works in opposite direction of the force applied and resists the motion of the box. Now if the force I am applying is more than the frictional force, then only the box will start to slide, otherwise it will remain on its place and will not slide. But the question is still there about what exactly happens at microscopic level, from where this frictional force arises. Actually, there are plenty of factors due to which friction occurs. However, the more prominent reasons behind the phenomenon of friction are molecular adhesive forces, roughness of surfaces, and the digging or deforming effect. We will go one by one. So, the peripheral molecules of the two surfaces in contact are attracted towards each other and form adhesive bonds. These bonds need to be snapped for the two surfaces to slide over each other. Surface roughness is another leading factor resulting in frictional forces that oppose easy motion. Most solid bodies do not have precisely uniform surfaces, that the respective protrusions and cavities would interlock amongst themselves. Even visibly symmetrical geometries are not regular and have protrusions as well as cavities. And when two surfaces slide over each other, it is extremely likely that the respective protrusions and cavities would interlock amongst themselves, leading to a force that restricts the sliding motion. Friction between solid surfaces can be overcome by reducing the roughness of the surfaces. One of the common methods to do that is by lubrication. Lubricants reduce the roughness and thereby the friction between the two surfaces. That is why we put lubricant in door joints, car engines, etc. If you want to get more detailed information about lubricants and also lubrication method and its types, please watch my other videos on both the topics. Now, as we have seen what is the friction, now we will move on to the next topic, that is coefficient of friction. In short, it is the minimum force required to get an object to slide on the surface, divided by the forces which are pressing them together. Mu is the symbol used to denote the coefficient of friction. It is unitless quantity. In short, the coefficient of friction can give you the minimum amount of force required to move an object from its static position, or amount of force that will be required so as to keep the object sliding by overcoming the frictional force. Now we will move on to the types of friction. Basically, friction is categorized into two types depending upon the state of surfaces those are in contact with each other or sliding over each other. These two types are dry friction and fluid friction. I'll repeat again, it is dry friction and fluid friction. So the dry friction is when the two solid surfaces are in contact with each other, it is called as dry friction. The best example which we saw in our example that when wooden box starts to slide over the table, it is the one of the type of dry friction. And fluid friction is, as its name suggests, that when there is a friction between two fluid layers, it is called as fluid friction. More viscous fluid has more fluid friction. Best example of fluid friction is honey. That is, when we try to take honey out from its bottle, it takes too much time compared with water bottle. So the reason behind is friction, that honey has to overcome more frictional forces between its layers which resists its motion. Now the dry friction is again divided into two types, that is static and kinetic friction. So the static friction is the friction which occurs between two non-moving surfaces. It is the friction that exists between a stationary object and the surface on which it's resting. If you try to push your coach across the room, the first push is the hardest part. It is because of static friction. When we want to make any stationary object to start to slide, we have to apply the force to overcome static friction first. Static friction is always less than the mu n. Now we will see what is kinetic friction. So when we want any object to slide over other and we start to apply the force, then once the object starts to move or slide, kinetic friction takes over. This is the friction that exists between two objects moving relative to each other. Kinetic friction is not as strong as static friction, and so it is easier to keep the shopping cart moving than to start the shopping cart from its zero velocity position. And now the last part of this tutorial, that is advantages and disadvantages of friction. So the advantages are, as we have seen, the friction plays a very important part in many everyday processes. For the instance, when two objects rub together, friction causes some of the energy of motion to be converted into heat. This is why rubbing two sticks together will eventually produce a fire. It is because of friction we can stand and walk on the surface. Also, while writing using pen or pencil, it is the friction between tip of the pen or pencil and paper surface because of which we can write. And if we list few of the disadvantages of friction, so the main is, or most common is, the machine or vehicle part requires maintenance work is because of friction. Since friction causes most of the parts wear and tear. Also, the performance degradation which may require replacement of machine parts. Increased energy consumption of machine is also the reason because of friction. Since to work any moving machine part, it firstly needs to overcome the friction. So this additional energy which is wasted to overcome the friction adds to the total energy consumption of machine. So these are the few advantages and disadvantages of friction. And so friends, this is all about the friction. I hope you have understood the topic very well, but still if you are having any doubts, please comment below, and thank you for watching.